Welcome back, guys. Look at our busy, bustling little empire going on. This episode is going to be slightly different. We're going to kick back. We're going to chillax a bit, and we're going to start with the airports. We're going to start with planes. What I'm going to do, rather than kind of worrying about the efficiency and all of that for one episode, we're just going to like look at stuff. I am going to like upgrade some lines and stuff, but for right now, we're just going to kind of look at stuff and see some of the stuff that we haven't seen. Now, first of all, I think we've got rid of all the planes because I want to get rid of this. This airport should have been within range of this train station and this bus station. But it's not, because I put it too far over. So, I have to do some terrain smoothing around there. Right, now these planes, we want to get rid of all of those. So, what's the easiest way to do that, I suppose? Did I name the we've got the airplane lines, airplane passenger lines. We want you, go to the depot and be sold. And you go to the depot and be sold, and you go to the depot and be sold. Right, so we've got rid of all of our planes, and we're going to replace them. Oh, we are going to replace them all with new aircraft. The Douglas DC-3. What an absolutely classic plane that is. Right, we're going to get, I don't know, like one, two, three. Three on each line from each direction. That's kind of what I'm thinking. So, so we want to put you on. Let's see. This is ice cream. So we want Barrington ice cream. So you three on there. And then buy another three. One, two, three. And we'll put those on the ice cream Winniston route. Cool. That's that. Then we'll whiz over to Winniston. We'll do the same thing here. So, aircraft, DC-3. One, two, three. And those go on Barrington, Winniston. And then buy another three. One, two, three. And those go on... those go on Winniston ice cream. I mean, I could have just gotten to replace, but I wanted to buy extra planes anyway, so this is probably the easiest way to do it. Here we go. Barrington. Depot. That's the depot. Buy aircrafts. Douglas DC-3. One, two, three of those babies. I can't wait to look at this. I can't wait to see these roll out of the hangars. You're going to be on... Let's see. This is Barrington ice cream. Got these names. And what do I want? Well, three more. One, two, three on Barrington Winniston. Alrighty. Cool. So we've just massively expanded. They're a million apiece, and I've just bought... How many? Six. I've just bought eight. I've just spent 18 million on aircraft. Cool. Should we look? I do love the aircraft. Let's get right down here. Here we go. Oh my god! Let's get you followed. Let's have a look at this. That is nothing short of absolutely beautiful. Look at the detail on it. And of course, because it's all silver and shiny, the reflections are incredible. Oh, we're getting lots of passengers coming up here. Oh, we got four waiting over there. Oh, the door opened. Did you see that? Oh, we've got to look out for that. I can't believe the door opened. Oh, you're just going to sit and wait. Let's have a look. Oh, that's one of the old ones taking off. Are you going to... is anybody actually going to pick these guys up? Oh, you're going off to the other airport, aren't you? Yeah. Oh, this is obviously waiting for some passengers to turn up. Zero passengers at the moment. What are you doing? He's just sitting there for looks. He's just showing off now. He's like, look at my new airplane. My God, look at that. The level of detail, the level of realism in the game is quite staggering. Now, why the hell is that just sitting there and it's not picking up the passengers? Answer, I don't really know. I haven't got it set to wait for full load or anything, have I? We've got more passengers showing up. Oh, right, now, this is the... I want to watch the back door. I want to see if the damn doors open on this. Because that was... I couldn't believe that. Let's have a look. Oh, it's on the other side. Yeah, look, the freaking door opens. Oh my God, the freaking door opens. I know it's a stupid little detail, but holy hell. So how many passengers have you got now? You've got 7 passengers. You've got 0. God knows what you're waiting for. I suppose they're all waiting for planes to take off and stuff. Now, apparently, you can buy extra runways. You can upgrade to extra runways, but I don't know how. Seriously, I don't know how. You're supposed to be able to. Barrington Annex. Yeah, no. No, I don't know. I don't know. Supposedly you can upgrade the runways, but I don't see how you do it. So you can have extra runways. I don't know. Yeah, that's by aircraft. That's the annex. Terminals. I've got 3 terminals, but there's no option for extra runways. No. Okay, well, it is what it is. Should we see one of these puppies take off? I think we should. Yeah. What's one that's actually got some passengers on it? It would be nice. You're going Barrington Winniston. Yeah. You know what? Let's rename this to Flying Blind. Well, let's change the name. So we've got... We definitely want to have a Flying Blind in there. But we'll catch the next one. Oh, this one's finally pulling out with the passengers. Hooray. Let's get you up there. Oh, we've got one coming into land. Oh my God, there's going to be a collision. Oh, near miss. Oh, he's ducked it. He's gone, oh no, I've got to go around again. Now, somebody actually asked a question and said, what happens if, like, the runway's full when other airplanes appear and whatever? Is he going to do a circuit and come back in? Oh, we've got to see this, guys. We'll do the takeoff in a minute. I want to see if this plane does a circuit and comes back in. Do we actually have air traffic control? Yeah, because there's nothing over there. There are no airports over there. So I think he's got to be, hasn't he? They've waved him off and he's going to do a circuit and come back in. Are you? Is that what you're doing, or are you taking some obscure route over to ice cream? Let's try that again. What does it say? It says you're going to... Yeah, it says you're going to Barrington Annex. I think he's doing a circuit. Oh, how cool is that? If that's the case. Let's speed it up to see. Yeah, he is. He is. He's done a circuit, and he's coming back in. Seriously, the airplanes in this are so staggeringly good. Oh, what are you doing? You doing more, another smaller circuit or something? Because the runway... Yeah, the runway's busy because there's another plane coming in. So he's doing another circuit. Oh, I love this. Now, isn't it weird? Now, if this was the boat doing this, I'd be going, oh, good. Oh, I think he's low on fleet fuel. I think he's going to crash. No, he's adjusting for his final approach. So, yeah, I wonder if they actually stack up. It's possible. It is possible. Here he comes. For a very, very smooth touchdown. Oh, don't you just love the tyre squeal? Oh my God, we could spend the entire episode just looking at these. It's the details. The doors opening, the tyre squeal on landing. You know, the fact that if the runway's busy, they'd actually fly a circuit. All of these little things are just awesome. I just wish I could figure out how to have multiple runways. Guys have been telling me you could do it, but I don't see an option for upgrading the runways anywhere. Somebody said, oh yeah, you have to click right on the runway. Well, yeah, that just brings up the same thing. Could increase the terminals, but not the runways. Maybe they're confusing terminals and runways. I don't know. I'm gonna have to do a bit more research on that. I want the plane. Oh, actually, I want to watch one of these properly take off. Let's have you. Get over here. Going to be doing some more naming in this, by the way? Oh, you've just arrived. Oh, let's go to another airport. See if we can find one about to take off. Oh, you'll do. You'll do. Airplane 22. You'll do nicely. Oh, there's no question the thumbnail for this video is going to be a really, really nice close-up of one of these, because they are staggering to look at, aren't they? Listen to the sounds. Look at the undercarriage! Oh my God! They're just too damn good. They are just too damn good. Not often you catch me lost for words, but I kinda sorta am at the moment. Wow. Okay, let's look at other cool stuff, shall we? Yeah, let's go and look at other cool stuff. What else would be cool? I tell you what, let's see how we're doing. How are we doing? We made 33 million, then we made 12, but I spent 17 million on new aircraft. So that's what, like, almost 30. Yeah, 30. Just over 30. And then this year we're making 6-7. So we're still flying, cash-wise. Let's turn the icons on. Because there's millions. There's loads of stuff piling up all over the place. We've got loads of food. We've got 337 food sitting here. And for some reason, we've got some livestock over here that... The game has obviously figured out that those livestock can be used somewhere. So it's shipping them around. Same with the coal that I put in. Yeah, where are we? Where did I put the coal in? Can you remember? It was around here somewhere, wasn't it? Yeah, it was definitely around here somewhere. Where's the damn coal? Oh, here it is. Here, I knew it was over this side. So, yeah, we've got the coal going. There's nothing over here. So it may be that it hasn't figured that out yet. Now, we are getting fuel. And I did see this when I first logged in. I wanted to show you this. Look at this. That's the construction materials, which you can see. There's lots of. We really need to do some boat upgrading. I might just get that done. Oh, that's the sparks fuel slag. That one I'm not upgrading. I'm going to just leave that one, because that's kind of going to be a little bit of a mascot. This one, let's get these set to set vehicle. We want to upgrade to Klondikes. okay, and automatic replace at 100%, yes. Okay, so that's that done. And then on this line, we want to do the same thing. So the Barrington CM replacement. Oh, it's that one's already set to auto replace. All right, so the ones on that line should be cool. Could probably do with another boat on this line. Oh, that one hasn't upgraded yet. Oh, this is Barrington Tools. Ooh, well, we should definitely upgrade that as well. So let's do a bit of replacement. Set vehicle, Klondike. Okay, 100%, yes. So that'll probably get upgraded now. Awesome. This is what I wanted to show you. We are producing lots of fuel. How much fuel have we got waiting? 150 fuel waiting to get shipped around. Look at this. Look at these canisters of fuel. How cool is that? Now let's have a look at the freight line for a second, because I want to see. No, that's not what I wanted. It takes a long time to bring up the list of stops because there's millions of them. Let's go. Lines. Here we go. Lines. Halo Freight. Now, let's see. We've got a frequency of every 8 minutes, which is actually kind of sort of not too bad. We've got 6 trains. Let's go down to the passenger line. We've got 7 trains on each of those. Yeah, I think we need a lot more freight trains. I've been kind of thinking about how we kind of upgrade this and how we improve this line. Now, for example, here, this bit would be easy. Pause, right? This bit would be easy because there is absolutely no reason why this should be connected onto this track. So we could actually get rid of those and run a third track along here. There we go. So now there's no interference, but it's not always that easy. So if we wanted to run a third track through here, when you get to the station, you have a problem, right? Now, one thing that we could potentially do, should I do this? I wasn't planning on doing this, but I'm kind of like into it now. So apparently, yes, we are. If I got rid of that, you know what? I'm going to take that right back. And then if I ran a little smooth along there. Right, now we'll find out if we can actually get this damn track in, having made that little change. Come on, go in, because this would be very cool. Oh, 7 million. Don't think so. Down, 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 down. Oh, yeah, mama. It works. 1 million and we completely avoid the town. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, that works for me. Right, done. Beautiful. Right, now what we need to do is get this hooked up onto this viaduct. Which, oh, we need to try and match the legs up if we can. So that, I think, would work. Yeah, nice. All right, we'll take that. Now, do we continue? Right, run it all the way around here? I think so, probably. Now, the thing is, again, we want to go potentially underneath this. Or over it. Or maybe over it. Now, what would happen if I run that? Let's get closer so I can get the end right. So if we ran it up to the end like that, right? And then, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the terrain and I'm going to raise the terrain here. Like that. Then I'm going to do a touch of smoothing. Run the track out like that to give it a bit more height. And then we'll try. Ah, now we're getting it. Now we got a chance. And I'm losing my voice because I'm so excited. There we go. Oh my God, does that just go straight in? That just goes straight in. Do I want to run it tighter into the station? I could run that tighter into the station, couldn't I? It's pretty damn impressive though, isn't it? You know what? I'm just going to put it in because I love silly bridges. Right, we're putting that in. Go. Cha-ching. So that's that done. Right, what else? What else? So then we'd come out around here. So then we've got the whole tunnel thing going on. Seriously, I was not planning on doing this. Yeah, is that enough for this episode? Because I do want to show you like other stuff. I want to show you other stuff. And I want to keep the game running as well. So we'll leave that like that. So that's at least kind of speeded up that part of the track. Let's turn off the dollar icons. All right. So how are we doing over here? Let's have a look at our wonderful passenger service. So you're coming around here. You've got 170 passengers. Whoa! And we just made a million from delivering them. So the passengers, some of the passengers got off, some of the passengers get on. Right. Now what are you waiting for? He's obviously waiting for the next train. Where's the next train? I think we need more signals in here, guys. Although, where the hell's the next train? It's a long way ahead. In fact, I don't see the next train at all. Seriously, is that the next train? That couldn't be the next train. There's like seven trains going in this direction. And apparently it is, you know. So what were you waiting for? I have no idea. No idea. Now, the other thing I wanted to look at is if we've got any bridges that are slowing it down. Now, this is that's a steel bridge, so that's fine. We got any wooden bridges? I don't think we have, but it's always worth a look to see if we've got any wooden bridges which would slow our trains down a lot. We've got one stone bridge, I think, that we could maybe think about replacing. So... no, that's all fine coming around there. We've got this stone aqueduct over here, haven't we? I think. That's not an aqueduct. There's a little aqueduct here. Oh, is this wooden? That's wooden. Okay, that needs to be replaced. Pause for a second. Let's get this replaced. Because this has got a speed limit of like, I don't know, like 37 miles an hour or something. So we want to change this. So we've got a choice now of concrete bridge, 124 miles an hour, or a steel bridge. And it doesn't tell us how fast the steel bridge. I think we'll go with the concrete bridge. I like those. Yep, concrete bridge goes in. And, well, no, not from there. And then concrete bridge on the other side. Oh, okay. That's just speeded that section up a little bit. And we've got... now, this is a stone bridge. Should we replace this with a concrete bridge as well? Speed things up? Yeah, what the hell. So... cool, that's that done. Standard tracks, high speed tracks. We're not going to go with the high speed tracks yet. We will eventually, but not quite yet. So, yeah, we'll go with that. And we'll go with that. Cha-ching! textures. Look at the detail on it. It's crazy good. All right, so that's that. Any other bridges that need replacing? Now, yeah, I should have probably done this in a time lapse or something, but I don't know. Sometimes it's nice to just chill and just like play a little bit, you know. We can actually have the game running while I'm doing this. Now, I do want to get some Flying Scotsmans going because I want to see them. And I'm sure you do as well. So, and the other thing, I want to get some more trains going. So, how about if we do maybe an upgrade on our trains? How old are you? That's the thing. The thing is, they're not going to be that old. Yeah, you're only 5 years old. So, I don't know whether I can do an auto-replace on them yet. I suppose all I can do is try and see. So if I said I wanted to replace these with... let's pause before you get to the next station so that we can test this. Look at this. We've got the Class A4. 90 miles an hour. And I haven't even put the Flying Scotsman in. Do we do an upgrade to the Flying Scotsman? Oh, man. I should jump to the A4s, but I want a Flying Scotsman. Maybe I just do one of them. Or maybe I put one new train on. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to say... these guys are going to be upgraded to the A4, and we'll do an extra train. We'll put an extra train on the line with a Flying Scotsman. Yeah? Sound like a plan? Yeah, go on then. So, A4s. So, set vehicle. A4. Add. This is the Mallard. So, we'll have a Mallard. Now, what passenger cars have we got? We've got the three-axle and a compartment car. Oh, we've got these BC4s now. Top speed, 75 miles an hour. 20 passengers. Oh, we're getting modern now. So, what do we want? We want to get rid of these ones. Now, before we had a capacity of about, 170 passengers right there. These with 20, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That gives us a capacity of 200 passengers. I don't think I can add more of these without expanding the stations. So I think that's what we're going to have to live with. So we want to set this to 25, yes. And go. Now, when you get to the station, are you going to upgrade? That's the question. I don't think we're at 25% yet. That's the thing. Let's follow you. The Blind Archangel. Sam Root's train. Here we go. Nah, it's not going to upgrade. They're too young. No, not yet. Okay, well, we'll have to wait for that to happen then. Let's find where the hell is the depot. Oh, I want to put a Flying Scotsman on because I want to see the Flying Scotsman. It's such an iconic train. Where the hell did I put the depot? It's over here. No, it's over. Oh, did I get rid of it? Oh, I think I got rid of it, didn't I? No, it's here. No, it's here. Right. Buy trains. We'll have a Flying Scotsman and... whoops, try buying it, idiot. Okay, buy and BC4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, cool. And we want two of these. Yeah. And so what we'll do is we'll put you... we've got a new electric train. The Class E94. I'm going to have to do some electricity. There's no question about it. You're going to go on Halo Line 1. Yep. And you are going to go on Halo Line 2. So we'll have one on each. There we go. Right. Let's take a look. Because these are beautiful. Look at that. When you think steam train, that's what you think of, isn't it? The Flying Scotsman. Oh, and look at those coaches. Those coaches are really, really nice. Oh, and we get the logo on them as well, the custom logos on them. Man, that is a long train. I don't think that's going to work with our existing stations. I think I'd have to upgrade our stations. So that's going to be the next job, I think. Right, so now he's fully onto the track. Let's have a look at our speed. Let's see how we do speed-wise. Miles an hour, 46, 47. He's getting there. That's one hell of a train, isn't it? I don't know. I'm thinking now that we've got these big carriages, we maybe should limit them to 8 carriages. 10 seems a little bit long. How are we doing speed-wise? See, we're only doing 56. Because we're limited by this bridge at the moment. That needs to be upgraded. I would like to see this get onto a section where it's... where it can get up to full speed. So here we go, we're going to pick up our first load of passengers. How are we going to do? We're going to get a full load of 200? It kind of looks like it, doesn't it? Yeah, this is not long... The stations are not long enough for this train. We need to expand the stations. Here we go. 98 passengers. Let's speed it up a little bit, because I just want to see what speed he gets up to. Here we go, 30, 40, 43. Are you going to get up to full speed? 50. Yeah, the track is clear ahead. 55. I'm so impatient. 58, 59. Yeah, we're almost there. We're almost up to full speed. And now we're approaching the station. 73. We got up to 73 miles an hour, which is almost top speed, which is not too bad. But yeah, we definitely need to increase the size of these stations. You know what? Let's go to the next station. Oh, it's a good idea. Let's go to the next station. Pause. What we want to do is upgrade this station. Now, will you just do it? No, of course you won't do it. Oh, that damn thing's in the way. Oh, okay. Yeah, we're going to have some moving around to do. So get rid of you and let's get a replacement. Oh, that might work. That might work. So, Rootbrat, upgrade. Oh my god, yeah, it can. Now, it's going to knock down some buildings, so this is going to cost 4 million to upgrade. Now, you know what? Can I go to a 320? You know what? If I took that out, I could. Alright, well, let's trim this back a little bit more. And should we upgrade to a 320? Yeah, what the hell? Do it. Alright, let's get some track in. Guys, I sense a time lapse coming up in the next episode, where I do a massive upgrade of all the stations and also extending the freight lines. Oh, too much curvature. Seriously? All right. Let's take this next bit of track out and run you down there. And there. Cha-ching. Right, let's see. Let's see how... Oh, look at this! Now that is a freaking station. Right, go. Wow, fancy Rootborough getting the first upgraded station. I bet Barrington will be upset. I bet they'll be very upset. Where's the Scotsman? That's not the Scotsman. What the hell? Is that... That train is... I thought that train was going in the wrong direction then. Where's the Flying Scotsman? It is you. You hang on. Aren't you going in the wrong direction? Did you get turned around or something? Let's have a look at the line. Yeah, you're going in the wrong direction. How the hell did that happen? Okay, let's turn you around. There we go. Right. I'm going to have to go and check all the trains on these lines to see that that hasn't happened to other trains. That's kind of weird. Right, let's speed things up. And we'll get this to the next station. So we can see how long this train is in comparison to the new platform. I'm gonna have to check out the vehicles after we've done this and see if any others have got turned around. Right, here we go. So Rootborough Station. Now this is a pretty big old train. How can we fit it all in? Oh, easily. That's about right. We could fit another couple of carriages if we wanted, like 12 carriages. Oh, you know, after this, I'm going to look the Flying Scotsman up and see, like, typically how many carriages did it have, and the Mallard, for that matter. All right, so there we go, guys. The Flying Scotsman, awesome. What else did I want to do in this episode? Well, we better check these vehicles out. So, yeah, you're working. And you. That one's in a tunnel, but it's working. Type in the tank engine. You're running. But are you running the right way? Yeah, you're fine. Then we've got train 19, that's fine, and train 20. Let's go and have a quick look at you. Yep, they're all fine. By the way, I didn't know this. Thank you for the person who left me the comment telling me. You can clear all the windows on your screen just by pressing the delete key. So there you go. Right, what did I want to... Oh, now, I did have one other request from somebody. Oh, pause. We've got a new vehicle, we've got a new bus. The Saura Tusha, I guess. Something like that. Let's have a look at the new line. Now, I don't think we've bought the Mallards yet, have we? No, we haven't bought the Mallards. We're still running in the old ones. Oh, I can't wait for the Mallards to get upgraded. What I was going to do, somebody asked me, was to have a ride on a plane in first person. Yeah, I don't mind doing that. Let's go and have a look at the airport. Anybody ready to take off? Oh, you're just about ready to take off. You'll do. Oh, and it's flying blind. Perfect. I've got some naming to do before the end of this episode. I need to do that. Here we go. Let's speed you up, get you into position. Oh, one coming into land. And here we go. How many passengers? 8 of 8. Right, let's go First person. Yeah, this is very cool. I am very tempted to do some kind of videos on the side where I just have rides. I mean, I'd love to do a ride, and people have asked for a ride around the Halo line, just in first person, just a ride around. And it does give you an opportunity to kind of look around and see the game. There's a lot going on. All right. It's a shame that you can't change the camera angle. You can, in first person, you can only look directly forwards. But it is very cool. It's kind of a big third person. He's still climbing. When he reaches altitude, the engine noise will change. It does create some incredible images, doesn't it? Listen to the engine noise. Oh, it didn't change. Normally, when they get to cruising altitude, the engine noise changes. Oh, there you go. Now it's dropped off. There we go. It's beautiful, isn't it? I do run out of adjectives after a while. All right, that's enough of that. What are we going to look at next? Let's round off, I think, probably with some naming. Now, I should have stuck with that aircraft. Somebody wanted... Now, where are you? That's Flying Blind. I keep finding Flying Blind. Where's another aircraft? I'll just go to the list. Go to the list. List of vehicles. Here we go. Because a new patron has asked me... here we go. Aircraft one will do. Has asked me to... Now, I don't think this will fit in. He wanted Ghost of the Demon of Razgriz. Now, I don't know why, but I'm pretty sure that won't fit in. So I think you're going to have to live with the Demon of Razgriz. The Demon of Razgriz. Because I don't think the Ghost of Wolf... No, it won't fit in. There's not enough room. So the Demon of Razgriz, that plane's going to be called. Weird. that's John. Actually, I don't know whether you'd like to be called John or Jonathan. Let me know. He also wanted a train. A bit greedy, isn't he? Wanted a train as well. I don't mind. I've got no problem with that. Look at all the freaking road vehicles. This is what's probably slowing the game down a little bit, is all the road vehicles. There's millions of them. I mean, literally. Right, we want a train. Here we go. Train. He wanted this called... he wanted this called Pip Pip Choo Choo. All right. I'll do that. Actually, no, he wanted it called Pip Pip Choo. Okay. I'm going to... No, you know what? We should have two chews. Don't shortchange yourself. Pip, pip, choo, choo. There we go. Done. Who else? Oh, now. David Williams, and that's David Williams, not David Walliams. David Williams goes by the name of Yorkie Pud, right? So we're definitely going to do some stuff for him. You can have a train. I think you can have a town as well. Let's have a look. Yeah, let's give you a train to start off with. The Yorkie Pud Express. There we go. Right. I want a town. You know what? Dartford. That'll do. Dartford. This is going to be Yorkie Pud. Yorkie Pud. In fact, should this be like Yorkie Pudshire? I don't know. Let's go for Yorkie Pudshire. Why not? Yorkie Pudshire. There you go. David, there you go, you're done. Road Vehicle 251 has reached its lifetime. Ah, and I missed it. Ah, okay. I have actually got a lot of upgrading to do. We've got three trains left on the Halo line to name. Gonna name them. This one is gonna be the Combat 601. Yep, Combat 601. That's John Barnes. Hey, John. Well, spell it right. Combat 601. Done. Let's have a look at that one. I'm sure you want to have a look at your train. And then this one is going to be... Now, this is Michael Cretchy. And he wanted Craycarth 25, which is his handle. So I always forget to delete the first bit. Craycarth 25. There you go. That's you done. And let's see. I might do more with that name. We'll see. And finally... Oh. Yeah, Edinburgh. Edinburgh wanted... Because he's got a son, Sam, and Nanny Giggles has got a son. This is going to be the Simon Alf. That's the name of their two kids. The Simon Alf Special. There we go. Boom. So we'll have a quick look at... you know what? Let's just run on a tiny bit. So there's that one. There's the Craycarth 25 in a cloud of smoke. And there's the Simon Alf Special, which I think, hang on, that's the Simon Alf Special. Is that passing the Craycarth? No, it's passing the Skystormer. There you go. Oh dear, so many trains! I haven't got anywhere near as much done in this episode as I wanted to do. What I wanted to do, or what I was planning to do, was to electrify this line, the Applejack line, and put one of the electric trains in here, just so that we could like see it. Now, I don't know what you think about that idea. Let's have a look. What happened? Like, because we haven't seen any of the electric trains, so we haven't seen the Crocodile, we haven't seen the A4/7, the Class E94, we haven't seen the Red Arrow. So yeah, I want to show you this stuff, guys. I think we'll leave the episode there, and when I come back, I suppose the next episode I'm gonna have to actually focus on the production chains a little bit. But let me know what you think. Do you want me to just like mix it up? And maybe on some of these lines, like this one, just put in some of these different trains so that we can just see them, you know? I mean, because I want to see them. I'm sure you want to see them. God, I really do need to focus on the production a bit, because we've got a lot of stuff building up and it needs to be moved around. So yeah, leave me your comments. Do you want to see a time lapse where I go around, upgrade all the stations, add the extra track in for the freight lines? Let me know what you want to see in terms of adding some of these weird trains onto other tracks. Do we want to go electricity yet? Do we not? I don't know. Leave me your comments. I love reading your comments. I read every single one. I will catch you for the next episode. I hope you enjoyed this. Peace out.